Discussion on perventricular VSD closure. Perventricular VSD closure is a hybrid procedure in which the cardiac surgeon opens the chest and the cardiologist passes a sheath through the right ventricle to achieve a device closure of the ventricular septal defect. Hybrid procedures are done in hybrid suites with facility for both open heart surgery and radiographic equipment for cardiac catheterization and angiography, that is hybrid of open heart surgery theater and cardiac catheterization laboratory or cath lab. Heart is exposed through a lower partial sternotomy. The advantage is that cardiopulmonary bypass is not needed. Intraoperative transesophageal echocardiography is used to confirm the size of the defect, its rim from the aortic valve, and the function of the aortic valve. The location of the ventricular septal defect is determined intraoperatively by palpating the region over the right ventricle with maximum intensity of the thrill due to the left to right shunt. The site for puncture is further confirmed by transesophageal echocardiography. The perventricular VSD closure system has a trocar for introduction through the right ventricle, a dilator, sheath for delivery of device, and the VSD closure device. The trocar is introduced through a purse string suture for the control of bleeding. Guide wire and sheath introduction is under continuous TEE guidance. Sheath is de-add by allowing a back bleed. The device occluder's right ventricular disc is secured by a suture to facilitate retrieval if needed. After accurate device positioning, the suture can be cut and removed. TEE confirms the device position as well as the good functioning of aortic and tricuspid valves. Cardiac rhythm is also checked to exclude conduction disturbance before the device delivery is established. As with other device closures, aspirin is given for a period of 3 months during which the device is expected to get endothelialized. Large VSTs in the epicomuscular region is difficult for the surgeon to access in small children. These defects require large sheaths for device closure, and the local complications are higher in small children because of the relative larger sheaths for the size of the child. Molay and colleagues report perventricular closure of such a defect with guidance of epicardial echocardiography. The 3-year-old child had multiple adjacent epicomuscular defects, the largest of which was 19 mm. A larger multicentric report of perventricular closure of 47 muscular VSTs has also been published. At midterm follow-up of mean 19.2 months, none had delayed development of AV block, increase in AV valve insufficiency, or ventricular dysfunction. 90% had complete closure of the muscular VSTs. Another study reported perventricular VST closure with left infraaxillary mini-incision. They used this approach for perventricular closure of 45 doubly committed subarterial ventricular septal defects, which were less than 8 mm in diameter. A multicenter randomized controlled trial comparing minimally invasive perventricular VST closure versus surgical closure for treatment of perimembranous VST has been published. 100 patients were enrolled and randomized in the study. The perventricular closure group had superiority in procedural duration, ventilation time, chest tube output volume, postoperative hospitalization time, and hospitalization cost compared to the surgical group.